I wanna stroll over heaven with you.
It will be like when I walk by your side. I can only imagine what my eyes will see when your face is before me. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Will I sing hallelujah? Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. I can only imagine. I can only imagine when that day comes and I find myself standing in the sun. I can only imagine when all I would do is forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine, yeah. I can only imagine. Surrounded by your glory, what will my heart feel? Will I dance for you, Jesus, or in awe of you be still? Will I stand in your presence, or to my knees will I fall? Sing hallelujah. Will I be able to speak at all? I can only imagine. Yeah, I can only imagine. Forever, forever worship you. I can only imagine.
I do want to say one, read the obituary, but I want to say one little story that comes to mind. 8 years ago, when we had came to Hilltop, first Sunday of February in 2016, we fell in love with Emma and Tom. And Tom would come to church so often and tell you he wasn't right with the Lord. He just took a liking to my wife. And Allison would always say, when he had one of them real good services, and my wife would always say to Tommy, And she'd say, Tommy, it'd be a good day. It'd be a good day. And she meant be a good day to make things right with the Lord. Every time for years, it'd be a good day. It'd be a good day. I'll never forget that morning when Tom was going into surgery. We just went and visited him. I didn't have to say a word. He was ready to pray. I didn't have to say anything. He was ready. And we prayed, and he gave his life back to the Lord. And here's what he said. He said, tell Allison, it's a good day. And just the other day, on January 8th, Emma went on to be with the Lord. And it was a good day for her. See, over there, and I'll not take James's message, but there's no cancer over there. There's no heart problems. There's no grieving. What a wonderful place it's going to be. She was the first person ever heard shout at Hilltop. I'll never forget. And I think you're going to play that song here in a little bit. We just got to sing and win her either way within the first few weeks. And she just let out a shout. And I'll never forget that. And she loved Jesus. And I don't want to say too much. She lived a life. And Brother James is going to preach here in just a moment. So, but it was a good day for her. And we can go to be with her. Emma Jean Shad, 70, of Parkersburg, formerly of Boone County, West Virginia, went home to be with the Lord on Monday, January 8, 2024, at Charleston Area Medical Center. She was born in Logan County on Christmas Day, 1953, a daughter of the late John R. and Rebecca Marie Wiley Woody. Emma loved the Lord, praising the Lord, and telling others of His grace and mercy, listening to gospel music and singing. She was a homemaker and member of the Hilltop Chapel Free Will Baptist in North Fork, West Virginia. She enjoyed quilting, shopping, especially at Gabe's, and eating at Cracker Barrel. Amen. Watching videos of her on her phone and MASH on television, and she loved spending time with her family. Her memory will be cherished in the hearts of loved ones, including her daughters, Crystal, Vest, and William, and Jessica, Arthur, and Christopher, son, Joshua Shad, grandchildren, Adam, Vest, and Casey, Ashley, Vest, Jessica, Nate, Vest, Rachel, Benjamin, Vest, and Melena, and Riley Shad. Great-grandchildren, Palmer and Callaway Vest, her siblings, Delmas Woody, Francis Woody, Samuel Woody and Kelly, Timothy Woody, and Letha Burchett, and her friend and caregiver, Layla Selden, to whom Emma's family would like to send a very special thank you for the love she gave. In addition to her parents, Emma was preceded in death by her husband of 41 years, Tommy Lee Shad, grandson Noah Shad, and two brothers, Tom Woody and John Woody.
Reached the end of life's journey. He'd been holding to God's hand a long time. As I knelt by his bed, my heart was thrilled at what he said. If I go or if I stay, victory is mine. I'm a winner either way, if I go or if I stay. I will still have my Jesus each passing day. I'll have a healing here below, or life forever if I go. Oh, praise the Lord, I'm a winner either way. Really know about tomorrow. We must prepare to go to heaven any day. While we're here, let's trust the Lord. He'll lead us safe to our reward. And by His grace, we'll be a winner either way.
I'm a winner either way, if I go or if I stay. I will still have my Jesus each passing day. I'll have a healing here below, or life forever if I go. Oh, praise the Lord, I'm a winner either way.
if I go or if I stay, I will still have my Jesus each passing day. I'll have a healing here below, or life forever if I go. Oh, praise the Lord, I'm a winner either way. Oh, praise the Lord, I'm a winner either way.
Far side of the sky, the first thing that I'm gonna do is spread my wings and fly. I'm gonna land beside a lion and run my fingers through his mane, where I might find out what it's like to ride a drop of rain. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. Gonna walk with my granddaddy, and he'll match me step for step. And I'll tell him how I've missed him every minute since he left. And then I'll hug his neck. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, there'll be only happy tears. I will shed the sins and struggles I have carried all these years, and I'll leave my heart wide open. I will love and have no fear. Yeah, when I get where I'm going, don't cry for me down here. So much pain and so much dark, this world we stumble through, all these questions I can't answer, and so much work to do. But when I get where I'm going, and I see my Maker's face, I'll stand forever in the light of His amazing grace.
I believe there are streets of gold, but it's all right with me if there's nothing more than worn old gravel road. And And I know a mansion's waiting, but a cabin suits me fine. Just a place where I can rest my heavy load. Oh, they say there is a river that flows beneath the throne, and the surface there reflects that holy place. Oh, I'm sure that all the splendor will be so grand to see, but what I long to see the most is Jesus' face. 'Cause that's all that matters to me, to bow my head and thank my blessed Savior on my knees. On those peaceful hills of glory in His presence I will. Of that fair city will never fade away. It's a perfect land where night will never come. But all the beauty I'll behold there can't compare to how I'll feel when I hear my precious Lord say, well done. 'Cause that's all that matters to me, to bow my head and thank my blessed Savior on my knees. On those peaceful hills of glory in His presence I will.
Thing for somebody 6 foot tall. For the family, you lost your mom. You know what? She's in a better place. Like Jeff said, you know, there ain't no more sickness and sorrows over there in that land that we're heading to. See, we're well. He's found that country. Amen. You got your Bibles. We've just read this. We don't know where it's going to go. I still try to trust in the Lord, lean on Him, and let Him lead and guide me. Amen. The Bible says in Isaiah chapter 9, nevertheless, the dimness shall not be such as was in the vexation when at the first He lightly afflicted the land of Zerubbabel and the land of Nephi, and afterwards did more grievously afflict her by the way of the sea, beyond Jordan in Galilee of the nations. The people that walked in darkness hath seen a great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath the light shined. Thou hast multiplied the nations, and not increase the joy before thee, according to the joy. And rejoices when He divideth the spoil. For thou hast broken the yoke of His burden, and the staff of His shoulder, the rod of the oppressor, as in the day of Midian.
For every battle of a warrior is with confused noise and garments rolled in blood. But this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulders, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and peace there shall be no end. And upon the throne of David and upon the kingdom to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice, from henceforth even forever, the zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. Now let me say, you know, Emma's been preaching her funeral for a long time. I just want to try to bring some honor to her life. That's my heart's desire and my prayer to God. I've come to find out that she really loved me and appreciated me. And although I'm just a human plumb full of faults and failures, there's one thing. I trust in the Lord. All my hope still in him. Amen. Everything I've got, amen, it come from Jesus Christ. And that's what she's come to realize. And maybe that's why she loved me so much, because I was just so simple. And the human race and humans have been fighting a war and a battle for years, good and evil. We've been fighting this battle for years and years. And all the way up until Jesus, we was losing this battle. We kept on dying. We never had no hope. We never had no hope. We was always just dying and leaving this world. But Jesus come into the world. See, the Bible says every battle of a warrior is fought with confused noise and garments rolled in blood. He said, but this shall be with burning and fuel of fire. Jimbo. Our Lord and Savior showed us the way. He said, I am he that liveth and was dead, and behold, I'm alive forevermore. See, Jesus is alive. He give us the fountain of youth. There's people today, I heard people today talking about having their hair colored and their hair dyed and people putting on makeup and people spending money. There's millionaires and billionaires spending money, amen, of trying to stay young. But Jesus is the fountain of youth. He that believeth in thee, though he were dead, yet shall he live, amen. See, Jesus is not dead, amen. He's alive. Muhammad's dead. Buddha's dead. They're all dead, amen. Jesus said, but I am he that liveth and was dead. And I've got the keys. I've got the secret, amen. I've got the way, amen. I am the way. I am the truth. And I am the life. He gives life and he gives it to us. More abundantly. The devil come to kill, steal, and destroy. Jesus said, I've come that they might have life and that they might have it more abundantly. Amen. So this battle that we'd been fighting and we'd been losing, amen, Jesus, amen, took upon him the form of a man, amen. Come, the Bible said, amen, in the likeness of sinful flesh to condemn sin in the flesh, amen. He come to condemn sin. In the flesh. See, there's none good. No, not one. Emma knew that. I know that, Jimbo. There's none good. Oh, but Jesus, amen. Born of a woman, born under the law to redeem them that were under the curse of the law. Amen. Brothers and sisters, we were all, amen, cursed, amen. We was all cursed by the law, amen. The Bible said, thou shalt not, amen. It said that 10 times, thou shalt not, amen. And there wasn't an 11th commandment that said, you do all of these and you'll have eternal life. Amen. Jesus is the only way. He's the only way we're going to get through the door. He's the shepherd, amen. He's the only way, amen. Everybody else, you try to come up some other way. The Bible said you'd be as a thief or a robber. Amen. So, this right here battle that we've been fighting and we've been losing, Jesus, when he hung on Calvary's Jimbo, and he had said it was finished. I want you to know the plan of salvation, the redemption of God. It was finished, amen, for me and you. For everyone, whosoever believes, amen, God sent not his son into the world to condemn the world, but the world through him might be saved. We've got a hope, amen, and it's all in Jesus. Outside of that, there is no hope, amen. There is no hope. There's false hopes out here to glory, to left, right, amen, anything you want to seek after, amen. Jimbo, I've said this many, many times. I could get a number three wash tub and a big spoon bowl and start beating on that thing. That drum, amen, just going up and down the road saying, I've got the way, and somebody would follow me. Amen, but I want you to know that same Jesus, amen, that they crucified, the apostle said, I've seen him, amen, and I'm witness, amen. It wasn't just Matthew. It wasn't just Mark. It wasn't just Luke. And it wasn't just John. And it wasn't just Peter and James. Amen. They saw this man alive because the night before they were cowards and they run, amen. The Bible said, you smite the shepherd and the sheep will be scattered, amen. Jimbo, they run for their lives. But on the day of Pentecost, they stood up with boldness, amen. They stood up with boldness and said, we've seen this Jesus that y'all crucified. We've seen him alive and doing well. Hey, there's something to that, amen. But there's the burning with fuel of fire. You kill Jesus, and there's going to be 12 people raised up saying the same things that he said. And that same day that they start preaching, there's going to be 3,000 souls added to the church. And later on, 5,000 more. Amen. That there's the fuel of fire. You don't put out a fire, amen, by throwing gas on it, amen. Amen. They killed Jesus and they throw gas on the fire, amen. That Jesus lit that fire in my life and in your life. Jesus lit that fire and they throw gas on it and made it bigger. What are you saying? I'm saying this right here, gospel. It's not. The Bible says the gospel's hid. It's hid to them that are lost. It's not hid to me, amen. Amen. Down in Lincoln County, Jimbo, on the other side of 14 Mile Mountain, something happened to me at an altar of prayer. And I raised up and I was different. And I knowed I was different. And they played a trick on me while I was down praying. Somebody turned the lights on brighter because when I opened my eyes, everything seemed to be brighter. Amen. The Bible said they that dwell in the shadow of death, on them hath the light shined. It shined in my heart. And everyone that's being born again knows exactly what I'm talking about. The very first miracle God ever performed in anybody's life when he saved their soul. And we don't know how it happened. We just know that it happened. Amen. I'm going to get one little Bible. Pharisees and them, they'd come to Jesus. Sadducees, and they were tempted. They said, this man died and his wife left and brother took her wife to raise up seed to his brother. And he died, and then the other brother took him. Well, seven of them ended up having her for wife. They said, whose wife shall she be in the resurrection? Jesus looked at them and said, ye do err, not knowing the scripture nor the power of God. Amen. They neither marry nor are given in marriage, but are as the angels of God. Amen. I'm telling you, God has got another angel, amen. Another one he's called home, amen. Amen. I'm telling you, she's got her wings, if there's such a thing as wings, figuratively speaking. She's got her salvation. She's got what she labored for. Other sister told me, amen. She said, I want to go home. And I know she wasn't talking about North Fork, amen. She was wanting to go with Jesus, amen. She was wanting to win that battle that the Lord won for me and you, amen. Scripture says, Jimbo, that did not he say that he's the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob? He's not the God of the dead. God of the dead. We've all got this hope. We've all got this hope in Jesus. And it all, Jimbo, every single bit of it all lies in Jesus. We've gotten so far away from the cross in the churches today. We've gotten so far away. But you know what? Emma's like me, amen, just a simple soul. She loved Jesus, amen. And all her hope and all her belief was in Jesus, amen. I'm telling you, outside of him, there's salvation in any other. There's none other name given among men whereby we must be saved. It's all in Jesus, amen. And they thought they were putting the fire out, but they dumped some gasoline on the fire, and it spread, amen. The Bible said, as many as been baptized into Christ have put on Christ. That's what happened, Jimbo, in Lincoln County, amen, in 1992. That's what happened, amen. I got filled with something, amen. Something come on the inside of me. It's no longer me that lives it, but he that lives it in me. It's what he done for me. Amen. My God is an awesome God. And the Bible said his name shall be called Wonder. And surely it is. Counselor. All the counsel in the world can't replace what Jesus would counsel you to do. The Everlasting Father. Oh, the one I like the most. The Prince of Peace. See, she wanted to go home because she had peace. There's a lady over at church. She's had a spot on her brain and been going to the doctor. Afraid it was cancer. She said, I'm all right with it, Brother James. Either way, I'm all right with it. You can only say those kinds of things if you know Jesus, amen. If you know Jesus, it'll be all right. Because he's not the God of the dead, but of the living, amen. He's the God of the living. And in that country, death will flee that country. There won't be no more death. There won't be no more shadow of death over there in that country. We'll be as the angels of God. Think about that. The angels of God. All right, we're going to shut up. I know that wasn't too much, but I pray you got something out of it, and I pray that you understand that burning and that fuel of fire. That's Jesus. They killed our Lord and Savior. And them 12 cowards, they run. But on the day of Pentecost, Jimbo, something happened to those boys, amen. Something gave them the boldness, amen, that this world couldn't take away. They were beaten. They were put in prison. Amen. They were threatened their lives, amen. They were threatened, amen. But they stood boldly and they proclaimed the name of Jesus because they knowed, amen, that if they died, amen, that they would be able to be with him and be resurrected, amen. I'm telling you, they know that down in their spirits, amen. Paul said, I must put off this tabernacle, even as the Lord has showed me, amen. We're going to put off this body of clay, amen. But I'm telling you, we're going to get a glorified body fashioned like unto his glorious body, amen. We're going to get a brand new body, amen. One, amen, that won't feel sicknesses or aches and pains, amen. I'm talking a brand new body. In Christ Jesus, amen. We're going to get it one day. All right, this time we'll call up our brother here. And we'll dismiss in a word of prayer, and we'll also dismiss over at the graveside. But we'll dismiss, and we want to pray for the family. God, I know I miss my mom so much. I know Jimbo and his mom died. I know, God, we miss them so much. Miss their voices, their little sayings, you know. We miss them so much. But you know what? I pray that this God of peace gives you peace to know that she ain't suffering no more. ain't going to suffer anymore. She's with the Lord. To be absent from this body is to be present with the Lord. Amen. All right, this time, if you would bow your heads. Almighty God, Lord, as we come before you, Lord Jesus, we want to thank you, Lord, for this, Lord, this precious soul, Lord, that you've called home. We want to thank you, Lord, for the privilege of being able to know Emma. We want to thank you, Lord, for what little short time we got to know her. I pray today that you would look down, Lord, upon this family, that they carry those memories in their heart, all those good things, Lord, that she's done. Lord, that they just carry them in their hearts and keep her memory alive, knowing one day, Lord, if everybody comes and accepts you as their Lord and Savior, oh, Lord Jesus, that they could be with you and be with her once again. Amen. I pray, Lord, that you would just look down and touch the hearts, Lord. I know today that they're going to be heavy. Oh, Lord, but you can overcome that heaviness. You can give us that peace and that joy. And knowing, Lord, that she's in a better place, in a better state of mind, Lord, I pray today that you'd just bless them. Help them, comfort them when they need it, Lord, and they just look to you, the author and finisher of our faith, Lord, they just look to you for each and every answer, Lord. I know today that you've got the answer. And Lord, I pray today that you'd just comfort, Lord, each and every one of them. And we'll ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen.